Do you ever wish you could get more done during the day? Or are you ever curious if you're maximizing your potential for achievement? Well, here are four productivity hacks that I use all the time to help you get more done. The first technique is the Pomodoro technique. It's a very old Japanese productivity technique. Let's be honest, we all have limited amounts of focus. And despite people always talking about grinding it out, we need to be rooted in reality and balance the fact that we have limited amounts of focus with getting stuff done. And the Pomodoro technique does an excellent job at this. The Pomodoro technique works like this. You work for 25 minutes, then you take a 5-minute break, and you repeat this cycle 4 to 5 times. At the end, you take a 15-minute break and go clear your head. Drink your glass of water, use the restroom, go walk outside, and then you come back and then you do another cycle. So you use those 25 minutes to focus on one task, get that thing done, then you take a 5-minute break, you can maybe check social media, just don't get sucked in, then come back and work for 25 more minutes. And when you try this technique out, you realize it's a great way for, again, balancing our focus with getting things done. I've included a link in the description below to a free Mac app that I use called Tomato One. It's a simple timer, very simple, and sets up the Pomodoro cycles for you. The second productivity hack that I love to use is intermittent fasting, or IF. I wanna shout out Greg O'Gallagher over at Kinobody for introducing me to this technique. IF is basically having mini fasts every day. An example of this is, let's say I stop eating at 8 p.m., I wouldn't eat again until 1 p.m. the next day. So that's a 17-hour window of fasting. Now, depending on your schedule, you can switch that around. The idea here is to give your digestive system a rest. And there are a lot of benefits to doing this. First off, I'm not naturally a morning person. So by me not having to make breakfast in the morning, it just makes my day start off that much easier. Another benefit, you have increased focus because your cortisol levels are way up. Another thing is, if you have caffeine on an empty stomach, by the way, black coffee and tea, if you're having those plain without creamer and sugar, those are basically zero calories. So that does not mean that you're breaking your fast. If you use sparkling water, that's a great way, because of the carbonation, to curb your appetite. If you can mix the increased cortisol levels, the increased focus, and caffeine, you become a machine. A couple other benefits of IF is the fact that you're able to focus better on your diet, whereas you're not eating a bunch of times throughout the day. You might only have 1 or 2 big meals. It's a lot easier to dial in your diet and make sure you're sticking on track. Another benefit to IF is longevity. There's been a lot of studies that have shown that if you do intermittent fasting, that actually increases your life expectancy. The third productivity hack is the one that I believe is the most important, is what I like to call the top three. This technique comes from a book called The One Thing. And The One Thing book talks about how to prioritize whatever you're working on in any given day. And the framework that they use in the book is, what is the one thing that I can accomplish that will make all other things either A, irrelevant, or B, easier? So if you use that framework, I have applied it to the to-do list. A lot of times we look at to-do lists and let's say it's 20 items. Well, almost like you're checking your Facebook or your Instagram or your Snapchat, you see those notifications pop up. That releases dopamine in our brains, and it's almost like a game. We love seeing these things, and the notifications make our dopamines fire off in our brain. The same thing happens when you cross off items on your to-do list. Here's the thing, being busy is not the same thing as being productive. And this technique really kind of puts us all together. So the night before you go to bed or early in the morning, you take the top three high priority items based off the framework that I mentioned before from the One Thing book, which I will link to in the description if you want to check it out. And those are the only three things that you should focus on first in the morning. From when I first get up to about noon, I have my phone on Do Not Disturb. It automatically is set up that way. So if someone tries to call me, it goes right to my voicemail. I use that early morning to go after the high priority three that I have on my list. In addition to using the One Thing as a framework to figure out which items you should put on your top three list, I also like to use this framework. If you have something that is kind of, you know, churning your gut and you're afraid of it, that's probably something that you should also include on the top three. Whether that's making those sales calls that you need to make, responding to those specific emails, or having that conversation, or doing whatever you really don't wanna do, and your gut is putting a knot in your stomach and saying, that's something I don't wanna do, that's probably what you should be going after. Another benefit of taking care of these things in the morning is, again, we have limited willpower every single day. And if you take care of the high priority items right in the beginning of the morning, you're gonna feel like, wow, I'm getting so much done, because you will be getting so much done. The fourth and final productivity hack is the 5-second rule, popularized by Mel Robbins. Now, we're not talking about dropping food and picking it up after 5 seconds. This technique will help you push through things that you don't want to do, but you know you should. I briefly mentioned this technique in a previous video, how to be more interesting, so you can go check that out if you'd like. I won't get into all the back end science on this because I can link to her video and you can check that out. But the big idea here is our brains are wired to avoid uncomfortable situations or potentially painful or scary situations. Our brains are trying to protect ourselves. But in our day and age right now, a lot of the things that are gonna get you to the next level are those scary things. The things that we don't really wanna do. They're uncomfortable. But here's the deal. When we wanna grow, we have to go through uncomfortable things. Behind every fear is part of what you wanna be in life. So you have to be prepared for when you come against those things, to be able to push through. And this is a great tool to help you push through. Obviously, it's good to have a certain amount of caution to help us survive in life. But again, if that spectrum is too far of us being overly cautious to the point where it stops us from achieving what we need to achieve in life, then that's where the problem happens. So the technique is pretty stupidly simple. Literally, all you have to do is when you run up against a problem that is that way, it makes your stomach turn, you realize, oh, this is uncomfortable, I don't want to achieve it. Literally, all you have to do in your head is count 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and do. It's crazy and it sounds bizarre, but it really works. What it does is it tricks your brain, basically set aside your fear for that moment and you begin on whatever you need to get done. Because as I'm sure you have experiences in your own life, these things, we have them in our head as this huge giant, but once we actually go out there and start to do it, we realize quickly that it's not that hard. And this technique helps us push through that initial phase of, should I do this or not? And it'll help you get stuff done. Again, it might sound too simple, but try it out next time you are running into one of these problems and see how it goes. I've seen it work wonders in my life, and I think it'll help you in yours as well. I have a really quick bonus productivity hack that I wanted to include here, and that is meditation. Before I started meditating, I always thought it was some sort of boogie boogie stuff that I didn't really see the benefit of it. But here's what meditation really is. It's just building your mind's muscle to be able to focus more. If you ever have certain days or certain periods of your day where you have too much going on in your head, your head's swimming, you can't focus, meditation will help you bring it all back and be able to focus back on the task at hand. What I recommend doing is going over to the App Store and downloading the Calm app, and it's free. And the Calm app will help guide you through meditations and it'll help you understand what the benefits are and how to guide you through those meditations. Thanks for tuning into the Upswing Report YouTube. Like, comment, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you can be notified when we release our next video. All right, see you soon.